You know, in my 34 years in the criminal justice system as a lawyer and as a judge, I've seen serial killers, I've seen contract killers, I've seen murderers of every variety and stripe, but I have to say, Mrs. Castor, you are in a class by yourself. What you did to David Castor can only be described as premeditated torture. And while you're not being held accountable for it here, I must say that what you did to Michael Wallace was also premeditated torture. And premeditation is not something we often see in the criminal courts, but it certainly is present in both of these instances. Now, as bad and as evil as that is, what you tried to do to your daughter, Ashley, is simply something that I find I almost can't comprehend. I've seen a lot of defendants come through this court system, including some whose parents tried to take the blame for what they did, but I've never seen one who was prepared to sacrifice their child to shift the blame away from themselves. You know, I listened carefully to the testimony of both your daughters, and I have daughters too. Now, they're older than yours, but they have a similar gap in their ages. And I listened not only to the wonderment of your daughter Ashley as she tried to comprehend what you did to her, I also listened to the horror your daughter Bree experienced in finding her older sister almost dead. You not only deprived those children of their father, but you were prepared to deprive them of one another. And I'm certain that your daughters, like my daughters, like most children who have siblings, expect and are comforted by the knowledge that when their parents pass on, they'll at least have each other to grow old and share life with. You almost succeeded in murdering one child and orphaning the other. You know, that ranks, in my judgment, as one of the most reprehensible things I think I've ever seen in the criminal justice system. I know that you maintain your innocence, but I'll tell you, in my view, the evidence of your guilt is overwhelming. Unlike many defendants who pass through my courtroom, you're not just a danger to the general public, you're a danger to the people who love you and are closest to you. And I believe that the sentence I'm about to impose will remove that danger once and for all. Upon your conviction for murder in the second degree, the murder of David Castor on count one of the indictment, it's the sentence and judgment of the court that you be sentenced to a minimum of 25 years and a maximum of life in the New York State correctional system. Upon your conviction for attempted murder in the second degree of your daughter Ashley Wallace on count two of the indictment, it is the sentence and judgment of the court that you be sentenced to a determinate sentence of 25 years in the New York State correctional system to be followed by a five-year period of post-release supervision. I direct that sentence run consecutive to the sentence I've just imposed on count one of the indictment. Upon your conviction of offering a false instrument for filing in the first degree on count three of the indictment, it's a sentence and judgment of the court that should be sentenced to a minimum of 1 3/4 years and a maximum of 4 years in the New York State correctional system. I direct that sentence to run consecutively to the sentence I've imposed on counts one and counts two of the indictment. There's a $275 surcharge. Ms. Castor, you have 30 days with which to appeal the sentence and judgment of the court. We are recessed.
Thank you, Judge. Okay.
She's in coma.
Okay, well, as soon as I get back.
Thank you.